All right, what's up, everyone? Welcome to All in the Nidus. It's a team league that we teamed up with All in to put on with you guys. We got about 8 teams in it, and we are in week number 4. Tonight will be Formless Bear Sloss versus Confed, and I am part of your host, Turtler. With me is Giggle Bear. What's up, man?
Not much, dude. Ready to cast some Clamor. It always feels like when we come back on Friday like that, it's been a while since we've cast it, but it was really only last Sunday that we
I know. Cast it does feel like we haven't done anything forever, but what has it been, like a couple days even for?
Yeah, math on stream, I don't know.
Yeah, I know, I wasn't even gonna attempt it, that's why I just kind of threw it to you. But yeah, I'm excited for this, man. I really like this all-kill team league because the maps are different, so we've had some really fun games so far, so.
For sure, man. It's really nice to see, like, I don't know, it's good because you know, the ladder maps, everybody gets really good at playing them, and you know where drops are coming from and where rocks need to be destroyed, but I really enjoy seeing new maps, and I honestly wish the map pool for ladder was just, like, a little bit bigger, you know? Because, like, it'd be nice to have some
a little bit more variation than possible, yeah. And I understand, like, it's already a nightmare to balance 7 or whatever, but, like, I get it. I'm with you there that it would be awesome to have a little bit more variation. So it wouldn't seem so repetitive, but it looks like we do have our players ready. Anyone who's just joining us and maybe doesn't know how this works, it is a best of 7 all kill, and I believe it's 2 diamonds, 2 masters, so.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Getcha. And they usually go. I mean, sometimes, you know, you would expect 4 O's and stuff, but they've always been pretty even. I don't think we've had, like, an entire all-kill. We've had, like, a reverse all-kill, but that's when games are already won, you know?
Yeah, we usually get really near towards the, you know, 6th or 7th game. I don't think we've even ever got it done in 4 or 5, so it puts on a pretty good show, man. And I bet by now these guys are starting to figure out these maps because we didn't cast it for 2 weeks, so they have, like, 2 or 3 more weeks under their belt of trying to figure out these new maps and everything. So that should be pretty cool as well. Let me just adjust my settings really quick. I was trying to get a little bit of playing in, but I didn't leave the game, dude. We're making progress.
Nice.
So, all right, we're going to go. The scoreboard's going to be up, but it's going to reflect for the teams and not necessarily the players themselves. This is a best of 7. But our purple Terran player in the bottom right left-hand corner of the map, playing from Confed, it is Honey Badger.
And his Zerg opponent, representing Formless Bear Sloss, the Red Zerg, Mr. Hyde.
Confed changed up their logo, dude. I like it. The shield, grew wings and shit.
Whoa. Yeah, they doubled it up.
Yeah, no, I really like that. It adds, I don't know. It's just mirroring the other side, but I really like how they did that.
It's pretty cool, man. Pretty cool. Nice little subtle adjustment.
Yep. Man, this is the map that we both really don't like.
Yeah.
Just because of that choke point.
Like, maybe there'll be some good games, and, like, honestly, as Terran and somebody who likes to drop a lot, like, it does look like it has possibilities, but it's just so different from, like, any of the maps that are usually in the ladder pool.
Yeah. Yeah, we've seen some Cygnitus play on this as well, too, so maybe we'll get some of that going now that we have a Zerg player in there as well, but I guess I don't hate it. I just think it's really impossible to try to take a third base on. Like, you might as well just get your 2 bases rolling and play this map off 2 base, because that third is impossible, man.
Yeah, it's really far out there. I guess there is that gold that you can take as a quick fourth if you somehow manage to survive taking a third, but I definitely feel you on that.
Yep. Yeah, looks like we've had some good games on this, though. It's not like they've all been cheese. We've had some macro games on this map already, so.
Oh, yeah, for sure, man, for sure. So it looks like from Honey Badger, at least, I believe it's a 3-rex Reaper as we start to see the first Reapers being built now. I imagine we'll see a command center come down behind this. It's kind of the luxury of maps where they have a smaller wall off and you can wall it off with racks. You can 3-rex Reaper and get an expansion. It's not all in.
Yeah, we'll have to see, man. Like you said, the wall is already out by the expansion, so at least they can take that if it fails or whatever, but... As you said, it is well underway. I'd imagine we're about to get that third. Yep, so it is full-blown. I mean, we knew it already, but that definitely confirms it now that the third Reaper starts. Yep. So the real question is going to be, when will Honey Badger, or sorry, Mr. Hyde find out about this? I don't think the Overlord has seen more than one just yet, right?
I don't believe so, no. And he's coming in now. He's going to see this. And when you see 3-rex, it's more than likely going to be, and when there's no add-ons on there, that's kind of the for sure tell. At that point, as a Zerg, I'd want to scout the natural. And we actually do see Honey Badger's SCV going down there to build it. So, you know, it's kind of scary when you see 3-rex as a Zerg. But if it's going to be Reaper, you literally can just walk this Overlord in And I mean, there's nothing that can touch it. So.
Yeah, absolutely. And he pulled it back a little bit. You could tell he was kind of hesitant. He didn't want some Marines to get it. But you're right, man. There's absolutely nothing to contest it. But I think he saw all he needed to see, really. I mean, he saw the first two barracks making Reapers. And now there's three in his base. So he knows very well what's going on.
Yep.
So.
And he's going to know by the number of Reapers that are now getting in a little bit of a tussle with the Queens here. Clearing out a couple of the Lings would be nice. Really, the three racks Reaper, it's great to build up the numbers. The two main goals are don't lose any and try and force out as many Lings as you can.
Yeah,
the drones are kind of a secondary thing, you know, and especially with speed now, it's going to be a lot harder.
Yeah, and I was wondering if he was going to drop a Roach Warn. Some players will immediately try to go into Roach Tech. Some players will fight it out with Lings. It's entirely possible to fight off with Lings, but I was kind of wondering how he's going to choose to do it. It looks for now like he will just go with Lings. No upgrades either, just regular-ass Lings, man.
Yep. And this is kind of why I personally like the Ling response to it, is because Roaches wouldn't be able to engage. You know, they'd be able to, like, fight the Reapers, but, oh, man. And now we see a little bit of Mistmiker here. Too many Lings going down, and the Reapers do survive, unfortunately.
Yeah, those were some really good grenades. Got off a lot of them at the same time, and now he got a lot of those Lings. So there's six more coming out. With these Queens, he should be able to hold, but that already did, you know, significant amounts of damage, I'd say, so.
Absolutely.
And behind I was just going to say, behind this, as you said, he dropped his natural very safely. So it's not like he's completely out of the game.
Would have been nice to pick up a couple of Reapers there with those Lings, but unfortunately, because of the ledges and, like you said, the grenades, a lot of Lings went down there and needing to be rebuilt to fight this number of Reapers here. So these are drones that you would want, you know?
Yep. And he did drop a Roach Warren, so maybe he is going to try to tech into Roaches instead. He's got a lot of gas, so I was kind of wondering where he was going with that, as well as his lair pretty early. But yeah, it looks like Roaches as well. Oh, shit.
Oh, the Nidus,
yeah,
dude.
Yeah, the Nidus is down. I love that play, though, because this map, dude, there's such a huge area back here in the main to drop it under. I bet you that's where he's going to hit with it. But that's a really good play, man, especially when you're really contained like this with those Reapers. It's going to be really hard to get out and, you know, do any damage, so.
Absolutely, man. And those Reapers are good, but they are across the map. This Nidus will come in, and there is not too much at home. I mean, there's a couple of Marines. Stim is way under halfway done. We see, I believe, a reactor and starport going down now. Yeah. So not it's enough. Pretty standard issue bio going on back at home, but is there going to be enough to stop what's coming out of the Nidus?
Not enough to deal with these Roaches, man. That's 13 Nidus. He dropped it right in the natural, completely not where I thought it was going to go. But as long as it doesn't get picked off immediately, he should be all right. If he sends his Queens in and starts getting that creep spread, he'll be fine. But I thought he was going to do it near the main and not near the natural. Not that I'm questioning his play, you know, but I just figured it would be in the unscouted position back there.
We'll have to see. The Nidus does go down now, and a couple of Roaches can be out. I gotta say, man, I'm not sure that I like that positioning of the Nidus. Obviously, we have full vision of the map and know that that back area was uncontested, and he does not.
Yeah.
But
oh,
still,
he's gonna do it
man.
Again. He's going to do it again in the same spot.
No.
Oh, shit. What are you doing? Maybe a couple more Queens. He's feeling, if you could transfuse it or something. But, yeah, that's just never going to happen, dude. That bio is too strong. I think he should have dropped it back here in the main. But, as you said, I mean, we have full vision of the entire map, so.
Yep, absolutely, man. So these Reapers are going to get cleaned up across the map. So a little bit of a saving grace there for Mr. Hyde as the threat of those is no longer.
Oh, okay. We got our wish. So it's going to be scouted. Yeah, it's a little late now, but shit, he might be able to get a little bit more damage done with this. As the Marines are going to take a little bit longer to get over there, maybe a couple Queens can pop out. And if you can transfuse it and give it some creep spread, you know, it usually holds a lot better. Oh, the Queens are out, man. This one I think is going to go over a hell of a lot better than the one before.
Absolutely, man. This is definitely what you want to do. So he does get a bunch of units in here now. SCVs are pulled off the line. They're going to come back, try and give it a go with fighting the Marines in front of them.
Yeah,
that's
going to be
Roaches,
Marines,
actually
though.
Going to get surrounded and picked
okay,
off
here we
here,
go. Reinforced Roaches needed that, yeah. Good transfuse as well, man.
Starting to look pretty favored for our third player here, Mr. Hyde.
Oh, yeah. And we didn't load with Gameheart. We'll have to tell him for next time to create with Gameheart, but that was the whole mineral line worth of SCVs that went down. So just like that, Mr. Hyde will take it with a pretty sick Nidus, man. That's the second time we've seen a Nidus on that map, but it just begs for it back there, dude.
Yeah. So I mean, and it's not like it's great that it's good for Zerg, good for, you know, Protoss if they want to drop back there too, and Terran, you know. So it's like all races kind of benefit from that particular ledge. Cool map feature.
Yeah, absolutely. So yep, we'll have to see. I believe loser picks maps from here on out, so we'll have to figure out how they do this. But that will be the first point for Formless Bear Sloth. First one to four will win. Yeah.
Just like that, man.
So
a quick and well played game. Good response to mass or three racks Reaper, especially after losing that big chunk of links too. I mean, he was kind of on the defense there.
Yeah, cool. They gave me host, so we'll be able to make this next one with Game Heart. I mean, it's no big deal. It just makes casting things a lot easier, so you don't have to guess much of stuff. Oh yeah, it's the biggest one. Oh shit, I gotta find this map now.
Oh yeah, good luck.
Goji. Okay, I got it.
Hey man, it's not KTV.
Is it Avex, right?
I don't care. What? No, it's Goji Greenhouse.
Yeah.
Oh, is Avex like the whatever type?
The creator or whatever?
I don't know nothing about that.
That's all right. You're not on the hook for it. I am. Oh shit, it's time for a captain fight. The team captains are going to duke it out. I don't know. Yeah, that's what he said in the channel. So, I believe it's two diamonds from each player, and then the masters come out. That's why it usually does head towards like a game number 5 or a game number 6. Sometimes we've even had it go all the way down to the last one, right?
Yeah, well, we've had, like players come out and pretty much like damn near sweep a team.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden the other player comes out and just brings it right back.
Reverses, yeah, exactly. That's why I like Alt-Kill format.
Yeah. When those masters come out, man, they can really lay waste to the diamonds.
Yeah. I don't know who the player is, though. I obviously know one of them, but... Is it Genesis?
I believe so, yeah.
Or
Genesis
Ice.
Versus... Oh, you're... No, yeah, it's Ice.
There cool. All right, so the next map will be Godzilla Greenhouse, or however the fuck it's pronounced.
Yeah, I'm not
sure about this one. I don't even remember this one. It must be the extremely green one, but that's just going out on the guess. Like,
whoa, look at that. It's called Greenhouse. I would hope that it's got some...
Well, that
some
one that said is it's like downtown is definitely not a city map.
What is that? Something of the Valley of the whatever,
yeah,
dude?
Yeah, Valley of the Temple or whatever.
Yeah.
A bunch of people joining us in chat. Let us know which team you're rooting for, whether you're for Formless, Bearsloss, or Comfed.
Yeah, man. Got a lot of fans in here from both clans.
Yep. All right, so let's just jump into the next game. Figure out if Formless, Bearsloss can take another one, or if Comfed's going to tie this up. All right, let me throw in some music, too.
Boom. Hit him with the music.
Hit him with a little bit of music. All right, so our red Zerg player in the bottom left-hand corner of the map, currently up 1 point for his team from Formless Bearsloss. It is Mr. Hyde.
And his opponent bringing out the Protoss for the first time in this particular clan war, the blue Protoss from Comfed. It is Ice.
Nice. All right, now let's figure out which map this is. I still haven't figured out all the names. I pretty much know them all by this point, but it's the names I still have an issue with.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, so this is the crazy ass one where you have a double natural with a gold and a blue. Gap. Oh shit. Next time we'll remember that, maybe. No, I'm just kidding. But we've seen some crazy stuff on this map so far. One really, really rushed game and then one kind of macro game, so.
Yeah, for sure. We saw almost somebody try and go down there and early take that gold and make use of it, but it didn't quite end up materializing in that game if I remember correctly.
Yeah. Maybe we'll get one this time around. Yeah, I think he took it, and once his opponent saw it, he just punched through and attacked him. I think you can attack through these gold right here. It's not completely walled off, although it really, really looks like it. There's like enough for a Ling or a Marine to fit through pretty much. So,
what an evil map maker.
Yeah, you know? Seriously.
Oh, so we actually do see an early Nexus come down from Ice, and after his gateway, so it's not incredibly early or anything like that, but that trying to capitalize on those gold minerals.
Yep, and the way this Overlord is passed, I'm not sure if he'll see it. It's going to get extremely, extremely close, but he might miss it, man. We'll have to see here in a minute, or in like 30 minutes when that damn slow Overlord gets over there. No, it's good. But yeah, so far, pretty standard opening. Nothing too crazy from either player besides the really early Nexus or whatever, but we'll have to just see both players went for it, so it's not as big of a deal.
Yep, we'll have to keep an eye on what tech once this Cybernetics Core comes in, and then... once a couple drones come in to saturate that natural, what type of tech comes down from Mr. Hyde as well?
Yeah, do you think he'll mine from the blue, or because he took this back here, he's just going to mine directly from the gold from the blue? Or do you think his third will come down? Like, there's so many options. I don't really know how to play this.
Honestly, as a Zerg, why not take the other? If you can place another hatchery there, why not place one and then just the gold
in the square and drop the third? Yeah, that's probably how I would do it, because you're so like in at that point, you might as well double down.
Yeah, for sure. And all your live reproductions coming out of there, so it's like your rallying is gonna be like that quick. It's not gonna be coming from all over, you know.
I hope he does it, man. I want to see a third come down there right now. But yeah, I think there's nothing too crazy happening that maybe we will get our first macro game on this map. That would be pretty awesome.
Yeah, I totally agree, man. So we do see some probes getting to work down from ice on the gold. Sorry, this is just like a learning experience for me. It's like, okay, can you actually mine from those? Is that what it's meant for?
Yeah,
but
seriously.
It does look like he's got that going on. And a resonating glaives is ice's choice right now. So we're going to see more than likely some adepts come in.
Yep, absolutely. I mean, it's kind of a given at this point when you get that standard opening, but some players are starting to change it up a little bit. But yeah, man, I do like that decision. I'm still waiting to see. Oh, we got our wish, man. Look at that. It's a little proxied, I believe, like it's off center of the square, but
we
got it where we wanted it, man. I hope we get a macro game out of this. That should be pretty badass. With both players having that gold economy, it should hit pretty hard. So, man, what a crazy map, dude.
The coolest thing ever. Like, dude, queens and shit can just be there. You got two queens reinforcing a base. It's just like having a macro hatch, but your macro hatch gets to fucking mine minerals, you know? Like, how awesome is that?
Yeah, it's pretty nice, man. I want to see a crazy-ass game on this, but I don't know how crazy it could be, because look at how few minerals there are. Like, if I can't select them. Oh, there I can. So 1,500, 900. Yeah, I mean, it'll mine out rather fast, but that's still pretty badass, man. I want to see how this goes. But he's going to start flooding, so it might not come down to that here in a minute. I think because he saw that gold, he's starting to freak out a little bit, man.
Yeah, I agree. And he's going to have a hard time here getting through these adepts. He has a lot of lings. Some banelings will definitely help.
Where is that
mothership core? If you knock down these rocks, does it get rid of it? Or does it... Like, sometimes I can't ever tell if they're destructible rocks or if they just, like, you know, explode and then they don't fall down.
Yeah, I wish there was a way to let you know if it was, like, creating debris or clearing the path, but...
Holy shitlings, man. This is a whole bunch. Like,
and the Banes, too. It's kind of like I said, dude. Once that Overlord went over there and saw that gold, he's like, nope, fuck this. I don't want to play against the Protoss on a gold base. And that is a lot of Banelings, man. So they're going to be able to almost take down all the adepts alone before the Mothership Forge comes in. Damn, stop the production as well. So
that debris, man, kind of awkward. That complete wall off is definitely saving ice right now. This map is pretty goofy, man.
Shit, if you're Mr. Hyde, you almost want to just finish off the debris and punch through there. You think that's how it works? Or I mean, that's kind of what we were guessing, but...
And no photon overcharge right now means that ice could probably... Or Mr. Hyde could actually probably punch through there, but with the number of adepts reinforcing, he's going to be losing a lot of links. So he just has to back up, just do another round of banelings.
Yeah, and with his 3 base economy, he can kind of slow down a little bit and kind of rethink. I think with this, he should be able to punch through the gateway and then just flood from there. But there should be an overcharge up available this time around. And that is a lot of adepts, too, so it's not like ice is out of this by any means. But this is going to be a pretty significant push, I believe, from Mr. Hyde. Look at that.
Yeah, absolutely.
Dude, like, that's so many lings just trailing in.
I think every Zerg likes seeing this type of swarm, man. He just needs to crack through those buildings, and he should be good to go wild on the adepts.
Yeah, so we figured out.
Gonna see it.
We figured out what the rocks do, though. They just clear the pathway. They don't generate debris. Yeah. I was wondering too, man, because you never really know. Oh, that warp in though, stopping the links from flooding into the base. That was a really good move, and now this overcharge is going to be able to help him pick up a lot of them. There was a lot of links, and there's still a few left, but he cleaned up a lot of minerals. Lings right there, Jesus, all of them, holy shit.
Yeah, man.
Oh man, and just like that, Mr. Hyde taps out. Holy shit, what a wall, man.
Very, very good play there from Ice, making sure that his pylons were being overcharged. The adept warp in to prevent the links from running in and getting massed around was awesome, man. Very well played.
Yeah, absolutely, man. I didn't think he was going to be able to hold the amount of links, I'm not going to lie. I thought the Banes were going to be able to punch through, but he sure as hell held, man. That was very impressive. So now we'll have to see. It's tied up. I believe it'll still be our diamond players. Or will the first masters come out now?
Questions of our time.
Yeah. Oh, no. It'll still be diamond. So this will be the last confed diamond.
Gotcha.
Cool. I'm just waiting for a map name, and we'll jump right into map number 3, guys. It is now tied up 1-1 in this series.
You mean this will be the last Formless Burst last diamond?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Yup.
All right, let me just ask him what the next map is, guys. Thank you, everyone, for joining us. Dyro says, hello, today is my last day. Wait, what?
Last day of what?
Oh, yeah, I think he's joining the military or something.
Oh, wow, man. Wow.
I think. I could be wrong, but I'm going to go out on a limb here and say I think that's what he's talking about.
Go, go, go. Spam StarCraft.
Yeah, seriously.
Man, I'm watching those links run back on the preview of the channel now. That Deadpool weapon was so clutch.
Yeah. Oof. It saved his ass. Yeah, that's what I said. Like, it blocked it and prevented the links from just coming in.
Yep.
And then Overcharge, good unit. Just cleaned up everything. The Oracles, too, man. It was insane.
So what masters do we have? Deadwing, we have KTV Mujo Gardens, we have that Valley of the Temple or whatever. So, yeah. And we've already played two.
So yeah, so we still have the downtown one, right?
Downtown. Like,
or,
what is,
or yeah, you said it, Valley of the Temple or whatever.
Yeah, but I don't remember the other ones. I'm trying to think of the other ones. Like, what? Is there like a volcano lava one? I just remember them by their colors, man. There's a lot of grass on some. Sauce King? Nice.
Alright, so I think he gets to pick the map then, huh?
We meet again.
Protoss Sogosu. Protoss the best race. Oh shit. We're getting outnumbered by Protoss, guys.
Out loud. Mujo Gardens? Yes!
Alright, it's your map.
Yay!
Giggle Bear, you got
everybody's
your wish.
Favorite map, dude.
Wait.
Can you tell me if you like one better than KTV?
No, I don't. You're right. Like, it is everyone's favorite map, dude.
Sometimes we don't go to, like, my second favorite pretty close is Deadwing or whatever. Dead. I don't know what the fuck that map is.
Alright, so let me just get everyone loaded in and we'll get into this map.
Man, we're so funny, dude. Like, by the we start off, we have a couple of people in the party. By the end of it, we roll with such a
yeah, because everyone just stays in the party the whole time.
Uh huh.
But yeah, as long as the teams don't have a problem with that, I don't have a problem with it. Like, we can let it leave them in here or whatever.
Yeah, for sure. And especially with CTL. By the way, big shout out to CTL. They run an awesome. Like, I don't know. All these clans are just super friendly with each other. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It seems like it's just like. I don't want to say routine because that sounds negative, but like it's almost routine for these guys to like play each other in Clan Wars. You know, they're super quick, super professional about it, so it's always a pleasure.
Yeah, and I think Compit has a site too, but I'm not sure if Formless Bear Sloths does. So I think if you want to get a hold of them, you do so through CTL or whatever. So I love CTL, man. It's a great community or whatever. That's who brought us all these teams to participate on the night, is for sure.
All right. Oh god, the pink snow. Look at it, guys.
This map is so badass, dude.
It is.
Alright, so our purple Protoss player in the bottom right-hand corner, in the bottom left-hand corner of the map. Directions are really hard for me today. Who tied the score up for his team from Comfit, it is Ice.
And his opponent in the top right of the best map in the map pool, the Yellow Zerg from Formless Bear Sloss, it is Sauce King.
We have no bias on this map at all, do we?
I know, right?
No,
it's got everything you want, dude. Yeah. It's got pink snow, pink trees, green grass. Like, shit's pretty awesome. We see a probe coming out here with a pretty early scout. Gateway going down, though, so no forge shenanigans or anything.
Yep. Looking to see what this drone did. It looked like it was off to do some weird stuff there in the beginning, but I think he was just making sure he wasn't getting cannon rushed, so I don't blame him there. You're playing a Protoss. Like, it's always good to just look, so... Looked like Ice was trying to get that natural block too, but he didn't quite make it there in time. So far, so good. Nothing too crazy or cheesy just yet. And yeah, Dairo's going into the military. Awesome. I remember, man. Well, good luck with that, dude.
You make a really good point about Sauce King not wanting to be cannon rushed because he sent that Overlord over to the natural to just hover above it for a little bit, make sure no cannons were going down and stuff rather than just sending it directly across the map. So, wants to be absolutely sure.
This map is so badass, dude.
It is.
Next time there's a pool, like a vote to get a new map in the pool, we need to just like get everyone to vote for this map, dude.
Like, I'm sure somebody would just like be like, this map is incredibly imbalanced, but it's like, look at this map. Why not just throw this map in the map pool? Like, we
I've
have
seen
fucking...
harder to take thirds than this one, like Abyssal, dude. I don't know.
You don't like Abyssal?
It's just hard to take a third. I think that'd be
shark?
The first balance with this one, right?
What? I honestly, this map probably is imbalanced. This is like, fuck, dude, I have no idea, but it looks cool and it's fun.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I'm not really one to say map balance. I think there's so many things different when it comes into play with that. Like, it's really hard to judge. Blizzard didn't
even think
Liberators would be an issue on Cactus Valley or whatever until it was tested. So I think it's really hard to figure all that stuff out, I think.
I have a really hard time with just the units in StarCraft. Like, I haven't really been able to... I got mad respect for people who, like, factor in the maps and how all the cliffs and shit fit together, you know? Like,
yeah, absolutely.
Pretty cool, man.
But yeah, nothing too crazy just yet. We have an adept coming out, and the Twilight Council's down, so we'll have to see if research starts there. But so far, we're off to pretty much the same game as last game. The only difference is there's no huge Ling flood started just yet. But we'll have to see, man.
Yep, absolutely. I wonder if maybe Sauce King saw that game and doesn't want to do yeah. the Ling flood because of it, you know? This is a different map, though. I mean, we can see... I just kind of got away that last game with those extra debris rocks and some of the pylons that he had there in his gateway. So definitely not the same map and not an option on this particular map.
Yep, absolutely. So Ice is checking to see Sauce King's third. He saw that it's not down. He's probably questioning whether or not there's going to be a rush. That might be why he's trying to wall up a little bit. But so far, because of Resonating Glaives, he's just going to push out some adepts so far. We'll have to see what his tech path behind that is. But there's a lot of links coming in, man. We were talking about a rush, and we may have got one. I was just waiting to see. Yep. Has the Baneling Nest gone down yet? Nope. Okay. Nope.
Drop Overlord, man. That's what's going on.
All right.
Some links are going to go in the front. Poking a couple of adepts. More than likely going to get one. Yeah, for sure. If not the second one. Where is that Mothership Core, man? They're going to get up into the main,
oh,
too.
God.
And get this pylon.
Darkosis pylon, no!
Oh, dude, and it could stop Resonating Glaives, too, which is huge.
Oh, yeah. He should be able to kill it before this one gets finished. As you said, man, that should shut it down. That's a huge pickup. Oh, he missed it.
No,
it had 20 health. Go finish the job.
Finish it. No, dude. This is horrible, let's see.
I mean, he did a lot of damage. Don't get me wrong. He took down 12 probes, so he's probably feeling pretty good about this. But, man, he could have shut down the entire production. He's going to go try to finish it right now. Oh, shit. Nope, the other ones were up.
Okay, yeah, it allowed the other pylons to come in time, so Resonating Glaives does finish. These adepts are going to attack that much faster now.
Yep. Yep, absolutely. Now he has overcharge on this Mothership Core as well, so he'll be able to kill all the Lings, but he did take pretty significant losses. Nothing game-ending, though, or anything, because if you look at Worker Lead, it's 23-24, so neither player is necessarily out of it by what just went down, but it looks like he's just going to continue to flood behind this because melee attacks come down. Okay, the third base starts. All right, so we might get a bit of a slowdown here, but I couldn't tell whether he wanted to keep punching through with this or start trying to macro. I don't think he quite knows yet either, so...
Yeah, I'm not sure. There's a whole bunch of Lings coming in here. So that's Sauce King's definitely looking to do some damage here. We do see a third going down, whether it's just for larva production, not sure. Ice starting to get on a good number of adepts here and a couple of sentries, too, with some good force fields, man. That could pretty much render the Lings null.
Oh, shit. And Ice is moving out right when a drop is going down into his main. Short Lando saying, I'm using my phone data for this. We better win. Oh, shit. The man's data plan is on the line, dude. No pressure or anything.
Right?
But yeah, I think he's going to be caught a little bit unawares from this drop here, dude. Okay, I thought he was going to poke in with those Lings and try to distract him, but he withdrew him back just to try to keep it.
Photon overcharge does go down. Yep. Shoo with Lings from the mineral line, at least for now. Going to poke at this pylon, but not be able to get it, unfortunately. Adepts moving out across the map with some sentries. This army is pretty scary, but it does not have a warp prism over it. So if he does kill, you know, this army, okay, don't want to lose his Lings.
Yeah, I think he should be able to clean up those Lings rather convincingly, given the amount of force fields and stuff he has to kind of split up the surround. He's going to need to pull a lot of his queens in order to hold this, or he's just going to start losing a lot of drones here. And he does have a couple spines coming down, which will help out a lot. I do like that decision. Oh, shit, that was with some good force fields, man. He's going to lose all these Lings before they're even into getting attacked.
Yep, absolutely, man. So he wedges himself in here and, you know, kind of with that mass, the Lings aren't able to get the surface area that they need. Going to get to work on that queen. Pick up the spine crawler, I believe that was. Roach is coming out now, though, which should fare a little bit better than the Lings did.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. So that was still pretty good attack, just getting all those Lings, but I think this is going to get pretty cleaned up here now that the Roach is out. He did take the Shade, though, so he's going to poke up in here and I guess kind of scout more than anything else. He's got to know that these Adepts are going to get cleaned up. But at least he got into the main, saw that there was no lair just yet, and saw that it is going to be just Roach tech from here on out. So he'll know how to prepare for that. He's got a Stargate coming down as well, too, so.
I, like, have to sneeze. Okay. Fuck yeah, got it. All right, nice. So Yeah, I think that was a really nice attack. And if these are the three original sentries that were with that army making their way across the map back to the base now, I honestly think that is a great attack, trading all of those lings. And I think it was like 7 or 8 drones for just some adepts.
Couple adepts. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. I'd say that's a good hold for sure. And now it looks like he's trying to just switch up his tech path a little bit. Maybe force out some stalkers instead now that the adepts are kind of worthless. Or not worthless, but, you know, the roaches are out. So I do like that too.
Call of Death's worthless.
Yeah.
There are a significant number of roaches. I don't know if roach speed. Okay, no, the lair is actually just started now.
Yeah.
So roach speed is not in. Not a lot of creep spread going on. So this is, you know, he's got a lot of units, but unfortunately, he's not going to be quite as mobile as you'd like him to be.
Yep, absolutely. I think he might be able to hold this, but the Void Ray follow up behind this is going to hit him pretty unaware. I'd have to guess, man. And the Warp Prism's going to be over there as well, so he'll have Warp Ins behind this. So I don't know, man. This is going to be a pretty important hold, and there's going to be 18 Lings to help with this. That'll help out quite a bit. So,
yep.
Orion says, such a good spot to attack. Yeah, man. That, he got a lot of damage done there. And he was able to wedge himself into that mineral line too, which helped things out a lot. I do like this from Sauce King, though, moving across the map and trying to poke into that third, maybe get a cancel off. That would be huge for him at this point in the game.
Yep, absolutely. And there really isn't anything there from ICE to defend that. Warp Prism even is over with the main army as it should be. And the third does get canceled. So a little bit of a consolation prize there. If Sauce King can just hold against this, we'll have to see.
Yeah, but he doesn't really have anything to go with that mothership for. So sure, it'll take forever. But the Void Ray's here as well. That's going to start melting roaches here. He's going to need an answer for that. Or they're just going to get wrecked. And as I say that, a lot of them are getting cleaned up. Money Force Builds as well, though. You got to give it to him there, preventing all that that roach from like creating a line, being able to attack into this. So this is a really good attack, man. Now that there's no anti-air, this Void Ray just gets to reign supreme, dude. I'm not sure he's going to be able to hold this.
Derping a little bit, attacking an Overlord there as the army. I mean, there are a lot of roaches being built, though, so eventually he will be able to move across the map. But yeah, this Void Ray is just worth its weight in gold, dude.
Yeah, and these Lings that were doing a lot of counter pressure over here got cleaned up rather convincingly, but they did get 20 probes done. So now I don't even know who I like in this game better, dude. I got to say Sauce King. He just doesn't. He needs some AA of some sort, dude.
Yep. So he is up 10 workers, as you said. Some Lings making their way across the map now. Third base is up for Sauce King, but he just doesn't really have an answer to that one Void Ray.
Yeah, that Void Ray is king right now. Look at it go, dude. It's just wrecking everything. There's only one queen, so we know if he sends that down there, it'll get picked off right away. He's trying to get queens out a number to handle it, but this one just gets spawned and cleaned up right away. We're going to get a base race with one Void Ray and some charge left. This shit's insane, dude. But he pretty much cleaned up a majority of the probes over here. It's starting to fall. You know, it's only 14 to 34. So as long as he can hold in here somehow and kill this one Void Ray, as funny as that sounds, he'll be all right, man. Oh, did he kill it? Where'd it go?
What, the Void Ray? No.
Okay, he recalled. Gotcha. Nice. That, what an awesome move, though, dude.
Yep, I think that was a really fantastic move there from ICE. These Lings still going to town, taking that Zealot, wreaking havoc in the main base. Let's take a look at the worker tab now. It is 14 workers for ICE to 36 of Sauce King. So if Sauce King can just hold on for a little bit and find an answer to this Void Ray, and really what he needs to find an answer to right now are these Warpins and these Zealots about to hit his base.
Yeah, and they have charge as well, so charge lots are no fun, especially when you only have like a Hydra and two Roaches to deal with it. So I'm not gonna rule him out. He does have, you know, literally double the econ of ICE, but he has no army, so this is gonna be the hold of the century right here. And I think the Void Ray still reigns supreme, dude, as funny as that is. Like,
absolutely, man.
There's one queen, like, that's it. So, oh, okay, there's two now, so that'll help out a lot, but...
These Lings, man, unfortunately, he wanted those back at home to help him defend. I mean, he's going to take a significant amount of damage here.
Oh, yeah, as soon as you say that, the Lings start hauling ass back to the base, so... Yeah, dude, and now there's two Void Rays, so there's no AA, there's only one Hydra left. I think I gotta say ICE has it at this point, man. He really needs to get some Hydras out, but there's only three in production, and it's, you know, everything's gonna die by the time they get out, basically. So.
Yep. So this is unfortunately a classic, you know, Zerg. It's great, or just anybody really. It's not just Zerg, but being up on workers is a fantastic thing. But at the same point in time, if you cannot defend your base, unfortunately, you will die with a massive economy. The game doesn't reward you for banking up a bunch of money, you know?
Yeah, absolutely. So maybe just even a couple spores or anything would have helped out a lot. But as we said, that Void Ray just kind of went unchecked. And when you have a complete army of charge lots behind that, you know, you've got to be feeling pretty good. So isn't even going to go with any production behind this. He's just going straight all in at this point, and I don't blame him at all. And just like that, Ice will make Confit pull ahead 2-1 in this best of seven.
Yeah, man, really nice play there. I don't think, you know, we were making a big deal about the Adept Glaives coming in. I think that was, you know, it would have been good to stop that. Maybe the Ling pressure in the beginning would have been able to do a little bit more, but I don't think that was a game-changing thing there. But at the end of the day, Adepts with Resonating Glaives really helped him win that game, and well played to Ice, man.
That one Void Ray, dude. Hero. Literal hero. Yep. So we're going to wait for our next player, and we'll see. It should be the Masters now, right? Because they lost two games, I believe. If it's going to be the same format every week, it'll be the Masters player now. So
yes.
Is there a list of the maps? Let me get that for you, good sir.
There is.
I can find that. Just let me know if they're like waiting on me to make the lobby or whatever, please.
No, you're good.
Okay. I'm trying to pull up the...
Oops, sorry.
The maps.
Your garden is overgrown and your cucumbers are soft.
Okay, here we go.
Sorry. Oh, there you go. He got it before you.
Damn. Oh, but he just linked the site. I specifically took you to the map pool. That's how we roll.
Sky.
No, I'm just kidding. But yeah, so there's a site with all of the information for this team league. It's been really fun, though. I'm glad they included it on us. Or I'm glad they included us in on it. That was really hard to say for some reason, but
for sure, man. I think it's awesome to be bold enough to do some different maps and show some different types of gameplay and stuff. So
yeah,
this is definitely one of my favorite events that we do. The maps alone are just really awesome to see.
All right, so where's the Millennium? Where is that the map?
Nope. Maybe that. I don't know. Yeah, idea.
Oh yeah, the other one was Hushuang Garden or whatever, and Ganymede.
Oh yeah,
there we go. Ganymede, Detox, Deadwing. I'm looking at the map pool as we speak, so trying to get a little more caught up.
Oh, I was like, man, all of a sudden it just came to you. Like, we were talking about not knowing the names earlier.
Wait.
Cheers, die. What's going on?
Is there Millennium?
No.
Okay, yes, yeah. I was gonna say there's no Millennium. You guys are just trolling me right now. So we will go to Giggle's map. Which one is it though? There's like four of them.
I don't know.
AEM Deadwing?
What is it? Does the map pool specify or does it just say Deadwing?
Yeah, I don't know. It just says.
What the hell, bro?
What the hell? Let me pull up the map pool and make sure before I don't load us into some bullshit map. Okay, Deadwing LE. Yeah, no, I was about to put us in the wrong one. Good thing I looked. All right.
I am Sauce saying I was positive I killed that pylon. I feel you, man.
It was at 20. 20 health, man. You got it down to 20, so that's all right, though. Shit happens.
Mm-hmm.
That's like still I said, very well played.
I don't think it was. I don't think it ended up being, you know, a game-breaking mistake. It kind of broke open the middle game a little bit, but like at the end of the game, I think it was for other reasons.
Yeah.
Shit happens.
S-King NA, thank you very much for the follow. We appreciate it, man.
Yes, what's up? Starting it early, man. Thank you very much for that.
Yep. We're just waiting for the next player too, so bear with us just 1 second. I'm gonna go ahead and put this screen up real quick. But yeah, thank you guys for tuning in. We hope you like what you see. I really like these clan wars. I have a lot of fun with them, as you said. So is it Ice versus Genesis? I guess so.
Yeah. Okay. I believe so, yeah.
Cool. Alright, so the next map will be Deadwing and it will be a ZVP. Oh shit, I put the timer up. Ignore the timer. It's a lie.
The timer is a lie.
Okay, this looks like the right map, right?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, I was questioning it because they all have really weird-ass names in the custom search or whatever. But we should.
And I don't know what's different. Like, when they're, like, LE versus TE, I don't know what that is. Someone probably knows, but I don't.
Yeah, me neither. I'm sure there's a reason for all that, but I don't know it either. As
oh, shit. Snap.
I thought he was about to leave. That's usually what happens after three pauses. No, I'm just messing around. All right, so the score is currently 2-1. Confed is up 1 point, so this is a best of seven.
Yeah.
Asura Visser, thank you very much for the follow. We appreciate that, guys. Oh. They have to unpause because we're not referees.
Oh my god.
There we go. It was a little awkward. I was about to type it in party chat, but... SCB beats BC. Wait, what?
I don't know.
We missed some in chat. So, but yeah, let's introduce these players real quick.
Do it.
Game pause. Oh, God.
The pauses are real, bro.
That was the last one. There's no more left.
Oh, no.
Oh, shit. Should be only on top. Versus bottom. Fuck. Okay, let me look for it then.
I don't know what the proper Deadwing is.
Well, they said it was Deadwing LE, but I don't see that even in the map pool.
Yeah, bro.
Just have them look for it. Can you guys find it? Deadwing LE not showing up. Okay, cool. They're going to find the map then. Yeah, I didn't see it.
Look at that. Marauder King LE is ladder edition.
Oh, shit. Nice. God. I knew someone had to know. Deadwing LE. I got nothing. Is this my name?
Thank you very much for the follow, man. Look at that. You got like the inharmony. Thank you.
Yeah. You got that shit in stereo.
Now.
I hope one of them is looking for the map, though.
Boom. He's the party leader. He's got it. Go, Ice. Go. Find the right Deadwing.
Oh, shit. He found it.
Deadwing LE.
All right. Mine didn't show up, dude. I swear. I'm going to screenshot this and host it on the website. No, I'm just kidding.
Like, just going crazy with it. The burden of proof.
At least he knew, because I wouldn't even have known, dude.
Yeah.
Cool. There we go, guys. Thank you for being patient and putting up with our trash admin turd zergler.
Oh my god. It's not good.
All right, we got it ready from one. All right, there we go, guys. Sorry about that. We won't get into the proper map this time around. As said, Confed is currently up 2 points to one of Formless Bear Slot. I thought it was going to be a Masters. Maybe he's just rocking the diamond tag because ladders just reset and everything, or...
No, he was Masters last season. I'm not sure the rules of the league or whatever, but they were talking because he was going to play in the diamond slot, but he actually couldn't play in the diamond slot. They were talking about it just specifically because he had made Masters recently. So.
Oh, okay. I got you.
I'm sure at least for whatever purposes of this clan war tournament or whatnot that he fits in the Masters bracket.
Word. All right.
Get with it.
Yeah. So we have the correct map this time around and everything, man. I'm pretty excited.
Yeah.
So, our yellow Protoss player in the top right-hand corner of the map, currently up 1 point from Confed, it is Ice.
And his opponent in the bottom left from Formless Bear Slots, the Pink Zerg, it is Genesis. Don't use the search feature. I don't know. What's the alternative?
Oh, shit. Tech4 is all willing to log in and help us out. Yeah, there's a 90-second delay, dude. Thank you for being willing to help us out with that. Hopefully we shouldn't run into that issue again, but we found the other three with no issue at all, so it was just weird to me that it wasn't showing up. So.
Yeah. Yep. I wonder what the problem is with the horizontal spawns on Deadwing. Maybe just with this little arm leg thing, the distance for rushes is too small.
Yeah. Yeah, it must be, dude. Just, it does look pretty close, but there's maps like that already in the pool, like Newkirk and shit. I don't know. It's kind of weird to me that they'd cut that out. Maybe it was just too overpowered.
I don't know.
Natural is really, really short. You can almost see it in the same screen. So.
But Ice goes and scouts it, though. So you can only spawn... Okay. So you can spawn people, like, vertical from you or diagonal from you. I guess what's going on here.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know why you would say something about it being the wrong map.
And then scout it? Yeah, no. Yeah. I'm thoroughly confused, man. I don't know.
Yeah,
up,
for
but...
sure, dude. All right, anyways. So he will eventually find him and figure out where he is. And for this particular game, it is Crossbone.
Yep. Absolutely. And Ice has got some pretty early gas, dude. He's already off to both, so I'm kind of waiting to see where that's headed, as well as he did take a really early natural, too, so. Indeed. Let's check in on that. We got some good banter going off. Oh, shit. Genesis taking an extremely early third, too, so.
Yep.
He's trying to distract him with chat and pop out that really early third. No.
And I don't know. Has the probe seen it? It's been up here kind of chilling right behind the mineral line. No, it hasn't seen the third. So it does not know, at least at this point.
He probably knows. I mean, it's, some people take it in between like 19 and 22. So it's usually not that early. But I don't know. It seemed a little early. But yeah, you're right. The probe is going to see it on the way back here. So.
Indeed. Good, sir. As there are a couple of lings working on this.
The probe missed it, too.
Did it? What?
Yeah, I just checked its vision. Completely missed the... He's got to know. Usually Zergs take it around 20 supply, so maybe he knows, but it's weird to me that he didn't at least poke in and kind of confirm for a fact that it was down. So we kind of have to see.
Interesting pathing on this probe here, too. Okay, it looks like he's going to turn around. I was wondering if he was going to proxy something.
Pylon, yeah. There. That's kind of what I was guessing as well. But yeah, so he didn't see the third. I mean, he probably knows about it, and he's going to get enough adepts over there really early anyway that he'll find out about it, but... Just wanted to see. That was a lot of gas, dude. I wanted to see what he's gonna go. Was he taking all that just for a couple early adepts? Man, I didn't think they needed double gas that early for it.
Yeah, I don't know. We don't see any sort of additional tech or anything like that. Just two gateways down now. I imagine in just a little bit here we'll see whether it's a twilight that comes down, a robo or something like that. You can see a probe geared up to build it. So.
Oh yeah.
Oh my God, it's a Stargate. So Stargate will be his choice.
Oh shit! Tanks can hit the third. From across the gap.
And weird back rock attack.
I got gotcha. You. From like right in here is where.
As a Terran,
about.
I don't see a problem with that. What's yeah. what?
Gibble's
what?
Like, all right, well, we're playing on the other one from now on. No.
For sure.
But yeah.
A lot of adepts, man.
Yeah, and so what is it going to be? Just adept Phoenix? I mean, that's a pretty popular play still. It kind of fell off in popularity, but it still happens quite a lot, so.
Yeah, I really like it. I mean, the Phoenixes are pretty APM intensive if you're trying to macro. I'm trying to get constant use out of them.
Yeah.
It's definitely... But just being able to have a group of maybe four or six of them, fly them around, pick off a couple of drones or overlords or something like that, and just have map pressure is definitely helpful.
Yep, absolutely. So Ice is going to go ahead and come take his third as well. And yeah, the Phoenix have started, but so far only one of them coming down. I was waiting to see kind of how heavy they go for it, because then as a Zerg, you have to start going more and more into the counter. You need an insane amount of Hydras to deal with it if that's going to be your tech path. So, but so far, I don't think he's even poked in an Overlord to find out really that it's coming just yet. I'll have to check his vision and see. It's going to be denied, so he's got to know now that they're coming out. So,
yep.
More that Stargates, feeling. Dude. Triple Stargates. Oh, shit. He's going for carriers, dude.
Oh my God, yes.
Kill him now!
Out here. The Overlord will scout it, though, so definitely did its job before dying. And Genesis already has his third, you know, set up. He's not quite droned up on it yet. He's got a couple of roaches, which I'm sure right now he's feeling like, oh.
Yeah, dude, seriously, like, well, I might as well throw these things away right now. But, yeah, we'll have to see what starts coming out of those Stargates, man. You think he'll start getting what, Corruptors, or do you think Hydras will be better? I guess it'll depend on what's coming out, but he's got to be second guessing things now. Maybe guessing getting his fourth down too, so.
Yeah, so we do see the Twilight coming down and charge, so it's leading me to believe that we're going to see, as you said, a move towards carriers. Right now, we just see like a. Two oracles being built, and I'm sure we'll see
it's the makings of that crazy ass pig build. Remember that one that we were like, what the hell just happened? It's like mass oracles or whatever.
I think we've seen this a couple times. We've probably seen it like two or three times, and it always seems to be going up against like small amounts of Hydras, and it just like laughably destroys Ling Hydra, dude.
Yeah, we'll have to see if that's what he's going with, but it is starting to kind of look like it. I never know when that build's gonna hit, dude. But the few times that we have seen it, as you said, it's been pretty ridiculous, man.
Yeah, dude, that build makes me kind of glad that I like don't have to play ZVP.
Yeah, there's some really scary comps depending on which way they go. But there's been no Overlord or anything that's poked in here anytime recently, so he's kind of playing blind at this point. That's kind of why I think this Ling is coming across, just trying to figure out anything. But it's not gonna find out too much.
Yeah, if he could get a read on these oracles, that'd be pretty huge.
Yeah, it's going to be get denied, though. Still no read whatsoever on the oracles, and they're coming out in force. So it will be that charge lot oracle crazy-ass pig build. Or maybe it's not necessarily pigs, but that's the first time like I got introduced to it. So I don't want to like miscredit the build. People get all mad.
That was blah blah blah.
Yeah, exactly. Like I'm sorry, guys.
No. So it looks like the adepts will shade whether or not they take it. Okay, yeah, they don't. Good call.
Still, just look at how many oracles are coming out, man. And there's not even a Hydra out just yet, dude.
Yeah, it's gonna be pretty brutal because those things are just building up energy right now. So.
Oh shit! The Nidus network is down. He's trying to just poke in here with pure roaches and just rely on getting enough probes down that it doesn't even matter. But I think he's gonna be really hard pressed to do that, man. Oh, swarm host coming out as well. This game just took a turn for the crazy, dude. But I don't know what's going to contest those oracles. As we said, when they get out in that number, they absolutely melt things. It was crazy the first time we saw it. I couldn't believe it.
Yeah, dude. Swarm hosts, like, they're pretty good, and it's always good to have free units doing damage. But I just don't think, especially with the number of charge lots out there, they're going to find the damage they need.
Yep, absolutely. This Overseer's not even going to make it in time to drop the Knight. It's just going to get picked off before it even gets over there. So he's probably starting to feel a little frustrated with this play. Maybe he'll get it down. Nah, it's definitely going to get picked up.
Gonna die.
Well, he's probably waiting on his swarm host count anyway, man. But these adepts shading up in here are going to see everything, including the Nidus network, which is a huge, huge scout for ice. Just knowing that's coming will make you spread out everything and try to figure out where it's going to come in at. And he has the phoenixes to pretty much deny it, too. So, but yeah, everything loaded up. We'll have to see where he's going to throw it at. So far, a bunch of swarm hosts. Oh, yeah, he's just going to poke them over. Can you shoot across this gap, I'd imagine? Yeah.
Yeah, it was foremost. Hell yeah, dude.
Yeah, so that'll be a really good pickup, but he doesn't have anything to defend this insane push coming in.
Yeah, the number of charge lots here is pretty huge. We do hear the Nidus come in as the oracles turn immediately back home and head right back home. Swarm house coming out now. The number of them still is, you know, fairly small. The adepts or charge lots coming in. Roach is taking a good position, but the oracle's going to come in.
And the oracle show up. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So things are going to be a lot different now that those come in. And there's going to be, as we said, really nothing to contest that. That push just gets so strong by the time it ramps up. So all the charge lots fell, but there's no answer at all for the oracles. It's going to kill the Nidus too, which leaves the swarm host stranded where they came from. And it just gets to start wailing on these mineral lines. So far, 28, 30. Holy shit, they just melt them so fast I can't even keep up. Yeah, did you watch that counter going off?
Dude, that was
insane. 38 drones went down in that aggression. So very, very well played from ice. All he's got to do now is clean up these couple swarm hosts, and he'll be all right in this game.
He killed the hatch, dude.
Oh,
he killed the lair, actually. Look at the number of spore crawlers going down in Genesis's main. Oh my god, dude. Mass Oracle is a crazy looking strategy.
Yeah, like if you allow him to get there, it's pretty ridiculous, man. So sure, but he did do a lot of damage behind this, but I don't think there's really any answer for the oracles, man. The roach is coming in as well. They're going to start getting cleaned up, and there's a lot of cannons down too. So he does get the third, though. Dude, that's definitely a really good pickup for Genesis.
So this game pretty wonky here. Zerg on three bases, Protoss on three bases as well, so definitely favoring the Protoss in that regard. And the number of oracles in the sky, honestly, I think is just unbeatable at this point. Spore crawlers will be really fantastic from Genesis, but at the end of the day, if you're just only mining off one base, it's not gonna be able to cut it.
Yeah, absolutely. And ice has 53 probes to Genesis 17 drones, so all he needs to do is squeeze out a couple bases and he'll be doing really, really good in this game. But he has the army. There's really nothing to contest this at all, and that is an insane amount of oracles. When those get a lot of energy, he'll basically be over be able to march and kill basically everything. So
Jeff DeChef, what's up, man? How's it going? Welcome to the stream.
Welcome to the stream and a crazy ass game, dude. Like, what the hell is this?
It's like Oracle Fleet, dude.
Yep, now a couple Stalkers joining the fight, and he decides to push with everything, including the Mothership Core. I don't think he's going to be able to really contest this at all, but it's going to be a nightmare trying to push into that main with that amount of spores.
Yeah, dude, for sure. Honestly,
the charge loss should do it, though, huh?
I just wish a couple of, I don't know, you're going to need more than a couple, but like some Corruptors would come out, you know?
Yeah, seriously.
Just be like, what now, Oracles?
Yeah, I don't know, man. This is ridiculous, though, dude. The amount of spores alone is going to make him reconsider this, but I think the charge lots alone should be able to clean up a lot of this. So sure, there's a queen and a couple roaches, but oh, wow. Good focus firing, too. He's actually able to clean up a lot of that, but the oracles are still reigning supreme, man, just melting down all of these spores. That was a pretty expensive attack, though, man.
Yeah, and more Oracles are going down, as well as he's got to back up here. Spores do actually reign supreme, bringing the Oracle number down to 5.
This game is ridiculous, dude.
What is this? Yeah. Is this StarCraft still? Because this game is nuts, man. I got to say, I still give the advantage to Ice, who's on 4 bases now with still a lot of probes.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's been 53 workers to 18 for quite a while now. But before, he didn't have those bases. He was down to just 2. But now, once these other ones get going, his economy is just going to blow away Genesis. But Genesis has the power of Zerg, and he does have 3 bases up too. So maybe he can just get off a couple really fat rounds of drones like he's doing right now. He just completely saturated his natural. But yeah, man, I think he's definitely got an uphill battle. So.
Yeah, man, more Oracles just coming out now from Ice. It's pretty nuts.
Yep, absolutely. Templar Archives is down as well. But yeah, Ice is pretty much, or Genesis is rather, is completely mined out in his main, so he needs to hold on to these expansions right now. If he loses either one of those, it's going to be game pretty much. I think he kind of knows it as he's starting to drop a lot of static D to try to protect those.
Yep, and he's got to reposition some of those spores, so that means that he's not going to have any at his, or he has one, but not as many at his main. It is a good choice, though, as the attack from the Oracles does come in, so he has the spores reinforced. Unfortunately, I mean, he just doesn't have much in the way of defense.
Yep, absolutely. So now there's a lot of charge lots as well. Probably try to poke in there again, but what a crazy-ass game, dude. Now yeah. It's just kind of a little bit of a stalemate because there's so much static D, he knows he's going to lose a lot to attack in there. I'd imagine he'll probably just pull back a little bit, let his insane econ lead take over and just try to get a little death ball rolling. I think he might be able to take it as it is, though, man. That's a lot of units right there, dude.
Yeah, I totally agree. I was actually going to say it's unfortunate because what's up?
Archons, a lot of Archons.
Oh, nice.
Yeah,
man.
That'll help out a lot.
Genesis is in a bit of a tough spot, man, because you need to be able to make sure that your bases can stay alive. So you need those spore crawlers to make sure that the oracles don't come in. But what you really need to do right now to have any chance of getting back into this game is to be just massing drones, you know?
Yeah.
So every time that he wants to build a spore crawler, not only does he have to spend the money on it for the spore crawler, but he's also losing the drone that could be mining. So he's in a tough spot for sure.
Yep, absolutely. And he's trying to force out that spire. As you said, a couple corruptors would reign supreme right now because the oracles couldn't do anything about it. But he's kind of neutered his economy in getting there. And instead of doing some really fat rounds of drones, he's just going to kind of get stuck in between. But I don't think that would have saved him either way. I mean, look at what's coming across the map. I you know, I'm not sure that would have mattered because it was 53 probes to 20 drones for so long. So
this is such a nuts army.
Yeah, now that the Archons are there, like with the Oracle DPS and the tankiness of the Archons, that's going to be a wrap, I believe. But we'll see, man. I'm not calling Genesis out of it just yet. He's going with Mutas as well. How many Phoenix are out? I think that'll kind of determine whether these Mutas find any damage. Oh, nope.
They walked on creep, and that was it.
Yeah, as soon as he saw that army, he's like, nope. All right, so Confed will take game number 3. And if they take this next one, that will be the Clan War. Oh, shit. No fooling around, though, man. They got straight to business on that one. The dude was waiting to jump into the party. Tails says, what league is this? This is All In The Nightus, a team league we did with All In, where we're just going to run 7 weeks of non-standard maps, or 9 weeks of non-standard maps. So, oh shit, hopefully I can find the correct one this time around.
What is the map going to be? The Hoang... I don't even know how to say that. Go for it. You
Hoang Chung.
No,
I don't know. Is that is this the correct one, though? I hope. All right, so the next map will be the mountain.
Is this the right one?
I don't know.
Questions of our time. Is this the right map?
Let me see. When we jump in here, I'll ask before we load in. All right. I'll ask him just to double check so we don't waste y'all's time. Thank you everyone for tuning in, though. It's been a pretty good night already, man. This could be technically match point if they win, but I don't know.
Yeah.
Okay, and it looks like the right map. I was like, please be the right map, dude.
Yeah, when we get in situations like this, I always kind of root for the player and the team who are currently down in the series to get for more games. So yeah. With that said, I am rooting for Foremost Bearsloss, at least on this particular game.
Yep. Well, yeah, and the Masters is out as well, so I think he should be able to take it. Wait, what? No Dante? Oh, I think that it's just, they're just bantering. Oh, he doesn't want to play PVZ. All right. So hopefully this is the right map. It will be another ZVP between Ice and Bidet Nevin. And as we said, if ComFed takes this, that will be the end of it. And they are up 3 points to 1 point for Formless Bear Celeste. So. But the Master's out, so.
Indeed, man. Uphill battle for Ice. Seen him win a clan war before, though.
Alright. Oh, now I gotta sneeze, dude. You put that curse on me. I couldn't hold it, though. I wasn't strong enough, Giggle.
Nice.
All right, so let me just throw up the scoreboard real quick. It is 3-1. All right, currently up 3 points or 2 points in this series from ComFed. It is our blue Protoss player in the bottom left-hand corner of the map, Ice.
And his opponent in the top right of the map, the pink Zerg from Formless Bear Sloss. It is Vednaven or Ved, Jesus Christ, Vednaven.
Yeah, let's go with Naven. Like, can we? Can we give people nicknames or no?
I don't know. Ved.
This is like freaking mono battle or something. Oh shit.
What were they building?
Oracles or
what? Oh yeah. So the probe does get to see. Yo, it gets the hatchery down, so that's pretty nice.
Yep. Always gotta love it when you can get it down and beat the dirty Protoss from blocking it.
Yeah, that always sucks. I hate that shit.
Yeah, this is one of the maps that is a little bit more on the standard side of things, given the map pool that this league runs on. It's actually really close to the one in the current pool where this rocks protect the third, and then you can split off to take the fourth. But yeah, I don't know. I'm interested to see how we're going to do on this one. It looks like they're going to macro up a little bit, but...
Yep.
We haven't had any, like, too crazy of a game on this one that actually sticks out to me, besides just standard kind of game.
I can see this map being an absolute nightmare for like PVTs where tanks get set up behind those rocks to like siege your third, and then you like, you know, load up your army and medevacs and fly them over. So you're attacking with your army, but you have siege tanks back behind the wall, dude.
Yeah.
Like, that'd just be a, like, this map definitely has some features on it that would lead to some interesting and maybe frustrating engagements.
Well, I want to see these rocks come down each time, but because you've got to kill this back one, I don't think it's ever happened just yet. But that's what I'm still waiting to happen. Just these rocks come down and then flood happen. But you can tell he doesn't want it to happen either. He's already got a probe over there just waiting, so. Have to see. Diamond, etc. Okay, so it's two masters and two diamonds from each team. But Formless Bear Sloss has already used both of their diamonds, so I think they only have masters from here on out.
Indeed, man. Possible match points.
Yeah, if ComFed takes this, that's match point already. It's just a best of seven all kill format. So we'll have to see. But it is a diamond playing a master, so you know, I don't want to rule it out or whatever. Diamonds beat masters all the time, but he definitely has his work cut out for him.
Not on my stream, they don't.
Yeah. Yeah, they've never done it on my stream ever either, so. I'm not even good enough to get matched against them, so I don't have to deal with that horrific ladder session just yet.
So it looks like Resonating Glaives is going to be the choice here from Ice, as he does have one Adept coming out. How many gateways come down remains to be seen, as at least one extra one does come down to be part of the wall.
Yep, and he poked a shade in and saw that the third was down already, so he just wanted to confirm that that was down. He's not even going to poke in and try to find any damage because he knows that's kind of a futile task, so he's just going to pull back and probably wait. But yeah, he does have two gas too. I'm kind of waiting to see. I guess just the Resonating Glaives is his only tech choice for now. A couple more gateways coming down. Yep. I'm not sure if he's just going to do the straight Adept all in or not, dude. We'll have to see here in a minute, but it's kind of looking like it for now. I do like this wall decision, though. Trying to wall off a little bit.
Yep. Very nice to be able to tuck in by that geyser there. And you get the couple extra gateways there that you're going to get for protection anyways. And they're nice, big, beefy, you know, units for a wall. So no banelings or anything like that. They're going to have a hard time getting through it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a lot of lings, though, man. Have we seen a baneling nest come down? Okay, so it's already down. Oh, shit. And as I say that, 9 banelings are being morphed in, too. So that's a pretty significant force that's going to pop through this wall here, man. We'll have to see if he can hold it. The mothership core is coming out, but it's not out just yet. So overcharge will not be available, man. This might be able to find some damage. But it should be out by the time it hits. It's going to be close as hell.
Oh my god, this is such a crazy.
This is so tense. Oh, it wasn't out just yet.
I gotta say, I think that was a good move. Even if he does die here, I think that was a very good move to bring the Adepts back so that they don't take the Bane hits.
Yeah. Yep, absolutely. But the production was stopped, man. Both the production down at the bottom and the production up in the main here. So really, there's nothing coming out but pylons for our Protoss player. And that's pretty much all she wrote. Sure, the Mothership Core can wail away on all these links, but production has ground to a complete halt, man. And I really doubt he'll be able to get these pylons. Oh, all right.
So it does come back up. The Ling's coming in here now, getting to work on the probes. There's only one Adept. 14 probes have gone down, and as you said, they may be cleaned up. The damage is done. Even more flood of Ling's making their way across the map.
Yep, absolutely. So there's not even a pylon. Oh, there is a pylon to overcharge. Okay, this might help out a little bit, but they got there too fast, man. That rush distance is just really tiny on this map. He's going to be able to poke in here and find a little too much damage, I think, this time around. So, a couple more Banelings coming in as well. If they find the mineral land, that's going to be a wrap. But I think just ending all this production right here is good enough, really.
So, yeah.
He's going to come up to the main and deny it again. That would be pretty much disastrous. Oh, shit, this overcharge up here on the main helped out a lot, man. We'll have to see where these Banelings poke in and if they can find any damage or not. Oh, no. The probes are coming out into the main. No.
Man, 34.
Jesus.
Absolutely beast mode Banelings there.
Yeah, those Banelings just found like the best connect ever, dude. Those probes were delivered right to him on the ramp. And now the production has been shut down again for the second time. There's still this lower ground production, but nothing's coming out of it just yet. So yeah, man, that was a pretty nasty rush on this map.
Yep.
He didn't even need to go through the back rocks, but I'm still waiting for the day that we see these back rocks come into play. Ridiculous, man, though, man. Ice is down to 2 probes versus 27 drones. All right, there we go. GG is called. And Formless Bear Sloths will gain a point. It is now 3-2. Sometimes floods happen, dude.
Yeah, he hung in there for as long as he could, man. After I got hit with those Banelings, I probably would have GG'd. But he tried to make it work. Unfortunately, the damage was a little bit too significant. And... but Nevin taking the win off a pretty strong Ling Bane attack there.
Yep, absolutely. So we'll just have to wait a minute and see who our next player will be and what the map will be. 3 again. All right. So who will be next from Confed? Still their diamond, right?
I believe so, yes.
Yep. Damn, he says that's 3 times this season he's killed 3 people.
Can't quite finish him off, man.
Yep. So we'll just have to wait for our next player from Confed and we'll jump into the map, guys. Thank you, everyone, for tuning in.
Just watch those Banelings crash into the probes again. Yeah. Jesus.
That was pretty much the end right there. There's a lot of Lings, man. And just denying all that production the entire time, too, is huge, so.
It's pretty brutal.
Oh, yep. Just hitting in chat, man. Gotta love delay, but it happens. All right, so give us just 1 second, guys, and we'll hop into this next map. Let's find out what he is. Oh, he's a Masters. Oh, shit. Masters versus Masters. This guy's a Terran.
We all love to see it.
Are you excited for this one?
Yeah, man.
TVZ at a Master level should be pretty hype.
Agreed. Will we see Ling Bane Muta versus Bai? Or will we see Mech? Who knows, man?
So what's left? Detox, Ganymede.
Valley of
That's
the City.
That's it. Oh, yeah, and then Valley, okay.
Alrighty, it's Valley of the City is what it's going to be.
Hopefully I can find it. Oh, shit, I got it. Hopefully this is the right one. One of our players is getting a drink. As soon as they get back, we'll hop into the next map. It will be Crux, the Valley of the City. And it is currently Confed with 3 points and Formless Bearsloss with 2.
I like whoever created this map because they really shot for the stars with the name, dude.
Yeah, they went all out.
That shit sounds intense.
Like, I want one that will never be based in on the map pool just off of its name alone. Like, no, that's fucked up. But all right, so let me throw everyone in real quick. Hopefully he's back. We'll get going. Got it ready from one. Wait for the ready from the other one, and we will jump into this. How do you feel about this one, man?
The ZBZ.
Oh, shit. Well, yeah, it's cool. So more Terran wins than Zerg. Maybe he just plays whichever one he feels like. He's like Mr. Giggle Bear. I can respect that.
The Dax said. Have muffins.
Yeah, this is a crazy ass map though. It's got a lot of space for drops and it's got a lot of space for like elevator moves, so I don't think we've got a straight up game on this one just yet, but I could be wrong about that.
Yeah.
All right, let me throw up the score. We'll get right down to it. So our blue Zerg player in the bottom right hand corner of the map, coming at us from Confed, it is Zatrannus.
And his opponent helping his team get back into it after Ice was kind of ripping through a man. We'll have to see if he can come back and put a stop, possibly win it. The pink Zerg from Formless Bearsloss. It is Vedenevan.
Yeah, man. I wanted him to play Terran, I'm not going to lie. I looked at his profile and it was like 11 Terran wins, 8 Zerg wins. I'm like, oh shit. Hopefully we'll get a ZBT, I just assumed. But that's all right. I don't hate ZBZ, I just like it when it gets past the Ling Bling Wars, because then it can usually turn into a pretty nice game. Not that that's not nice, but you know, that just happens a lot. I'm a Zerg player, so I've had my fill of Ling Bling Wars.
Yeah, that's
for
fair.
10 lifetimes, not.
I kind of like seeing where they, maybe like a 14 or 15 pool or something like that, will go and attack like a hatch first, and you know, the hatch first player is able to defend. I like seeing it, you know, how the different ways you can defend it and how kind of the different builds work against each other, you know.
Oh yeah, for sure. I mean, I don't hate it at all. I actually, it's one of my favorite mirrors to watch actually, but yeah,
don't lie. No, I really don't like TBT for as far as mirrors go.
Playing it seems like a nightmare. Sometimes it's fun to watch, in my opinion, just because there's weird variations that can just catch the other player off guard and like end the game. But I don't know. I bet it's a nightmare to play. But so is ZBZ, man. They're just different. But
yeah,
different nightmares. But so far, this one's off to a pretty standard fight. Nothing too crazy, man. I was wondering if we were going to get some cheese just to get a quick tie in the series or something from Vedenevan. But so far, so good. SC2 Chimera, thank you very much for the follow. We appreciate it.
You the man. Thank you. We are making our way to, I guess we could talk about this while we have a little bit of downtime. We're making our way to 500 followers, guys. When we hit 500 followers, we have a pretty sweet giveaway. We're not 100% sure what it is, but it is going to be extremely sweet. Is it for sure? I think we're going to try and do something from Proto Quick Printing. I guess
hopefully
we can reveal that little bit of information.
Yeah, he does everything. I think anything is the possibility. That's why it's such a pain in the ass to figure out what it'll be. But it should be something pretty cool. So we'll do that whenever we hit 500. And then we also have a tournament tomorrow night for Plats and Diamonds. So if you want to get in on that, the sign-up button is underneath our profile. And then we also have a huge clan war for $50 on Sunday. So we got all kinds of content coming up. So if you like what you see, hit that follow. Thank you for everyone that has so far tonight. But we don't have to waste too much more time because we already have a plus one and Banelings coming down. This shit is about to go nuts.
I really like this build. The plus one really kind of can help you if some roaches get popped out, you know, later or something like that. So, and it makes your Lings just that much more effective.
Yeah, absolutely. So the Baneling Knights are about to finish up at exactly the same time. But the real big differentiator so far is Vedenevan has gone for the plus one melee. I think that'll come into huge play here because that just starts completely shredding the other Lings once it kicks in. But Zatrannus has his third out pretty early as well. So let me see. It did get scouted though. So, I mean, each player has an advantage. We'll just have to see who can make the most out of theirs. So, oh shit, La Cucaracha joining us in chat. What's up, man? How you doing?
Indeed.
Yeah, I'm confused at what the banter is. Like, wait, what?
I don't know. Maybe it was just for Scout in the third.
Oh.
As we see Van Devin go and grab his own third. I don't know, man.
Yeah, I don't know.
Hard times in life, I guess.
He's like, fuck, it's going to be one of those ZBZs. He already sees the Banes coming in, and he knows he's going to be in a little bit of trouble. He doesn't have any defensive Banes of his own just yet, nor does he have that Wall of Queens or whatever that you really want to see. So he's going to lose his third right away. Yeah, man.
Uh-oh. Van Devin definitely kind of in a tough spot here.
Yeah.
He's caught a little bit without Banes. Those Banes are going to crash into them, but they do not kill them all. The Lings will eventually be cleaned up, so...
Oh, those Banes on the ramp were money, man. Getting at least five Lings right there. So, as you said, this will be cleaned up rather convincingly from Vide and Evan, but he doesn't have his third just yet. So, that was the price he took to clean this up. Now, I'd imagine he's going to want to get across the map, use that plus one to his advantage, and get that third going. Oh, I get it. Those dots were because he forgot speed. We've all been there, man. It sucks.
Yeah, for sure. He was lucky that it didn't end up playing too much of a factor, by the way. Shironan, 55. Thank you very much for the follow.
Denied the third again. That's huge.
Yeah, tough spot in a ZBZ to have your third knocked down multiple times. There are a lot of Lings here, though. As long as he doesn't take bad Baneling shots, he should be okay, as he does get a huge surround, man.
Yeah, and he has that plus one, too. So that plus one is huge in this stage of the Ling Bling War. As long as he is, like you said, if he can avoid those Blings, he'll be a lot better. So far, he's managed to avoid huge losses, but I don't think he's found enough damage that he wanted to.
Yep.
He's got a huge econ lead, though, man. It's 41 drones to 25.
Wow. So.
And he's got that contain just from denying that third each time. This is going to be the third time it gets denied here, so that's huge in a ZBZ.
Yep, the Banelings are making their way around the backside there, trying to be sneaky, but the Ling Bling War continues with Vednevin having a significant amount of more Lings, so should be able to shoot this away without too much problem.
Yeah, it looks like he's stabilized for now, and with that plus one advantage, he'll be able to get in here and try to get some damage done, but Roaches are already out. So I think with plus one, he should be able to get this, provided he can get a really nice wraparound, but if he doesn't know that wraparound... Oh, this Bane too! Oh, that was tense, man, but he needs a really, really good wraparound right here in order to deal with this. Even then, it's going to be an uphill battle.
Oh, huge shit, yeah. And really nice for Zatranis. He's going to be able to shoo away those Lings, at least for now. But the Banelings are reinforcing with Vednevin's Lings.
Yeah, absolutely. And he's still really far behind in workers by 20. So he needs to get in here and find a lot of damage, or he's just going to be out of the game. So I like this attacking this third, but I'm not sure that he's going to... Okay, he will.
He's
going to lose a lot of Lings,
really,
but he'll get it.
Him.
Yeah, absolutely. But now... how do you contest with all these roaches when they move across the map?
There was a Baneling attack that went into Zatranis' natural as well, and it got seven drones. So sniping the third and getting seven drones for those Lings and, you know, a small number of Banelings, I think it's probably worth it, though. He's got to be careful as we see a large portion of roaches moving out across the map, though, that could intercept this pack of Lings.
Oh, yeah, and it'll be able to deal with this rather convincingly. Okay, so he's going to pull away the Lings. Hopefully he can prevent from losing all them, but as we discussed, man, he doesn't have enough to deal with this. Or if he does, he needs to withdraw all of his Lings and consolidate him and get that wraparound, as we said. But it looks like instead he's trying to push through them and get a lot of damage done, maybe withdraw them back to the base. I do like that decision from him, though, man. Maybe prevent those roaches from attacking. So
yep.
So far, the queen went down at four drones, which is a pretty good pickup, but he lost a lot of Lings in order to do that, man. They were dying that entire time they were being sent across the map because they had to run by the roaches. So,
yeah, and we see a Roach Warren going down from Vednevin, but unfortunately, he's behind on the roach count, man. Zatranis has such a larger roach count.
Yeah.
But he's kind of, Vednevin's kind of trapped on it because he doesn't have the gases to go mutas or anything like that. So,
yeah.
Definitely in a tough spot, man.
Yep, absolutely. Frosty Phoenix, this isn't the Plat Diamond. This is our clan league. So if you want to play in tomorrow's Plat Diamond, you can still do so. The sign up is underneath the profile. Hopefully we can see you there. This is just our team league between Formless Bear Sloths and Confed. I do really like this from Vaden Evan, though, just constantly sending in lings and trying to withdraw these roaches. He knows if those roaches were to hit right now, he'd be out of the game. So he's trying to stall that for as long as possible, and he really needed to do that. So, but I don't think he's been able to macro up enough yet. It's still 25 to 48, dude. That's huge, and there's really nothing to contest this.
Yeah, still I just feel lings. Like it's in Zatranus' best interest to definitely just go attack now. Like, yeah. For better or worse, ignore these lings unless it's a major pack that gets through. You know, if this ling pack gets past his roaches, maybe go back home. But at this point, just go attack, man.
Yeah, he's got the safety banes. He's got four of them sitting at the natural alone. That should help out a lot. But yeah, I'm with you there. It's time to get across and get some damage done. So, all these bane hits, man. I'm excited. Oh, that was a really good one. And he still has one more defensive baneling. Oh, but it missed. It missed, yeah, so and now there are a lot of lings up in this natural.
That is a lot. I do believe the, well, I don't know. I mean, those are plus one lings, so they will rip down buildings very quickly. But if Zatranus could just consolidate his probes and try and fight with the reinforcing roaches, he should be able to go across the map and just absolutely bop Vaden Evan.
We're off to a base race. It's going to be lings versus roaches in a base. Nah, I don't know, but damn near it's going to end up being it, dude. We'll have to see.
Yep, pretty much.
So far Zatranus is not withdrawing at all. He's going for the base race, man. This is nuts. Oh, but does he know about Vaden Evan's little ninja base? I think that's all going to come down to that one little base, dude, in the top right-hand corner of the map.
Yep, I totally agree that it will, man.
I don't think the Overlord saw it go over there or anything, dude. Holy shit. So we kind of made a joke, but it is coming down to a straight-up Ling versus Roach base race. So all these Roaches are popping, but they're getting picked off as soon as they pop. And, yeah, what a ridiculous turn of events. Okay, he's actually going to withdraw now and try to deal with this. So these Lings need to clean up all these buildings before the Roaches get here, or Vaden Evan is definitely out of this game.
Is there any drone that's on the map for Zatranus? I mean, dude, he's going to lose 0-3.
But
he
I don't think
two
he'll...
extractors, a lair, and oh my god, dude, he's
hurry,
gotta get
roaches,
back.
Hurry, roaches, hurry!
Oh on,
god,
dude.
It's down to like what, one extractor? Oh, two extractors.
There's
holy
no
shit,
way.
This
he's
is so tense.
This,
yeah, it was a base race. Here we are making jokes, and it all came down to a straight up Ling Roach base race. What a crazy ass game, dude. At least we'll get our game number 7. Holy shit! Just like that, FXB ties it up, and we'll get a game number 7.
Absolutely, dude. So that's kind of the price you pay for not just being decisive and moving across the map and laying down the hammer.
Yep, absolutely. I gotta say that was insanely played from Vaden Evan that he knew he could win that and just sent the lings over there. I would have never guessed to do that, and I guess that's why I'm not a Masters player, man. That was nuts.
Yeah.
So we'll have to see. This is the last one either way. Well, no, unless he wins, right? Because we're on the game 6.
What? Who? What?
Is this game 6 now? Right?
Yes.
Yeah.
No, so that ties it up 3-3. So this
okay.
Is game 7.
Yeah. All right.
Get with it, man.
Yeah, no, I'm trying to figure out how many more players come out. That's what screws me up. It's going to be a Masters no matter what, right?
Yep, Masters. This is the last one no matter what.
Cool.
No matter what, unless we draw.
Yeah, they're asking what map this is. We do a map, team league on non-standard maps, and this is it. It's a 9-week team league, and we're on week 6 or 7 or something. I don't know.
Yep.
Funny thing about the Lings is I think they could have killed the Roaches before plus one range kicked in. Yeah, that's what I was saying. Maybe a huge wraparound and would have got it, but I don't know, man. And sometimes it's easy to guess those things when you can see the whole battlefield. That was a nuts-ass game, though. I'm glad. Oh, shit. They're about to see it because of delay. It hasn't finished up yet. Oh, shit.
Yeah, weird.
No!
That's funny, man.
Yeah, I didn't think it was going to come down to that, dude. It's a crazy ass
game. Yeah, man. That ninja base. Tricky stuff.
Yep. Roaches should have hurried up, dude.
Everyone's... Oh, man, that's brutal.
Yeah.
That's brutal. Alrighty.
Yeah, we're just waiting for the player, guys. Give us just one second.
Do we know the last map? What's the last map?
Oh, well, I guess from process of elimination, it's got to be Detox, right? Have we not seen Detox?
I don't think we have now.
Okay. Look at that. We're figuring shit out. It only took us 6 weeks in the league, dude, but we got it. Oh, what a crazy-ass game, dude. Like,
it's funny.
I never would have thought it would have been a Ling Roach base race, man. Like,
yeah.
I've seen some shit now.
Those plus one lings, man, just tore shit apart.
Yeah, that was nuts. But just even having like the, you know, the knowledge to know that that's what he needed to do to secure the game was amazing to me. And
oh,
you
last
know
night
it was well.
Ganymede.
Oh shit! Did we play Detox?
Yeah.
No. Oh, sorry.
It's fucking gay.
Okay, which one is it though?
The Ganymede.
There's like 12 of them.
That's so they just need big bold letters like this is the one you want to play, Ganymede.
All right, there we go. Hopefully this is the correct map. All he had to do was keep 5 roaches back and then go kill him with the rest.
Just sat there and went back and forth. Yeah. I kind of get in that same situation when I play Terran and it's against Mutas. Like, there's just a point where you're like, I can't defend this, so I'm just going to move across the map and try and kill him, you know? Like.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, I thought he was good with just the safety banes. He had like 4 or 5 banes, and they found some really good connects, but just not enough, really. So that was a good game, though. I really liked that game. We've had some really good ones tonight, and it all comes down to this, so I'm glad we got our game number 7. So...
Indeed. We got a little clan banter going on in the chat.
Yeah.
Love it. Love it, guys. You guys have been awesome. Everybody seems to really get along between these clans and CTL and all that stuff, so. Fucking yep. Awesome to work with.
Yep. Absolutely. So we got our players. We got our map. We're just waiting for them to ready up, and we'll jump into this last game of this best of 7. It's been some fun games to get here, though, man. I like this map pool.
I agree.
Me, don't burn the candle at both ends as it leads to life of a hairdresser.
It's
getting
deep in here. Deep. Yeah. I know. The ocean is in our chat, man.
All right. So we're just waiting for him to ready up. He asked for him not to cheese him.
Try not.
I mean, you could throw it out there and hope for the best, right? Like.
Please don't hurt me.
Yeah.
Ganymede, a weird map, man. It's weird. I don't like it. Mm.
Yeah, my bad. I didn't mean to leave you hanging. I was getting a big old drink right there. I'm sorry, Giggle Bear. I left you hanging. But yeah, no, it is a weird ass name. All right, so we're good to go.
Let's do it.
We're having a little banter detour, man. I can't blame him, though. Sometimes you just gotta talk some shit.
A banter detour. Alrighty. So it looks like it's gonna be a TVZ on Ganymede.
That's a good way to end things, though, man.
I agree. Everybody likes TVZ. And if you don't like TVZ, then get out. You do like TVZ. Don't lie.
Oh, yeah. Thank you, everyone, for the follows. We got like 4 or 5 in this very short broadcast, so that's pretty good, too. Thank you guys for the support. It's always fun doing this league. We try to do it each week. We've missed the last couple of weeks, but we'll try to get in on the next ones as there's probably only like 2 or 3 more weeks of this, and then we'll have to see where it goes from there. But yeah, thank you to both teams for allowing us to cast this. This has been really fun.
Yep.
All right, so I will give you the Terran player. So the pink Zerg in the bottom right-hand corner of the map coming at us from Formless Bear Sloths, it is Vede Nevin.
And his opponent, first time on the Nidus, I believe. I don't think we've seen him before. The blue Terran from Confed. It is, oh my fucking god, Imba.
Nice.
Sorry, I won't say the whole thing.
I'm hoping we can just shorten that to Imba. Is that cool? Like,
yeah, that's fine.
Can we agree on that? All right.
Indeed.
Good. All right. Why does it feel like I don't remember this map, dude?
I don't know. Because it feels just kind of like a pretty standard. It looks and feels like a standard map, man.
Yeah.
Oh, this is the one I kind of do remember. This is the one with the numbered. So it's like, this is your third. This yeah. is your fourth, you know?
Perhaps we should take up basket weave.
Perhaps.
Our chat just went off the deep end, man.
It brought. First chat, converted people unbreak to yourselves. So you see the spawning pool going down now from Vede Nevin. Pretty standard stuff. And it looks like a Reaper. More than likely a Reaper expand from Imba.
I want another base race. I'm not going to lie. If this shit doesn't end in a base race, I'm going to riot. Tell the players. No, I'm just kidding. But that was a crazy-ass game. I'm still so hyped from that last game. That was nuts, man.
That was pretty cool stuff, man. +1 lings. Pretty strong stuff.
Yep. So, as you said, a very standard game so far. Reaper expand on the Terran side of things, and a very standard expansion on the Zerg side as well. So, Nothing too crazy just yet. This map kind of lends itself to maybe some drop play from either side, maybe an elevator play out of the Zerg or something. But other than that, as you said, it's fairly standard in the grand scheme of things. The third might be a pain in the ass to take, but other than that, it doesn't look too crazy.
Yep, it's a little bit far off, but yeah, everything's pretty normal in this map. There's a good amount of ramps as you approach the center of the map, so that can definitely be weird to fight on for Zerg. But other than that, man, it's, you know, pretty standard issue third.
Yep, nothing too crazy just yet. We'll have to see who you guys are rooting for. Let us know if you're rooting for FXB or if you're rooting for Comfed, as this is the last map of this best of seven. So let us know who you're rooting for. I'm sure we're just going to get a lot of troll answers, but we'll see, man. Right. You never know with this crowd. Everyone's going to root for All In or something. Like, wait, what? But yeah, this Reaper's just poking in here, trying to see what it can find. But so far, we have the factory down as well. So I don't know if this is the makings of a 2-1-1 or if he's going to switch things out. But that's kind of what it's looking like. And I don't blame him on this map because, as we said, it kind of lends itself to drops and such. So.
Dude loses the Reaper, which is unfortunate there, and immediately Nevin moves out to take that third, knowing that there isn't any pressure of his drone dying to a Reaper.
Yep, absolutely. So he's got this Overlord out here, too. We'll have to keep an eye on it and see if it's going to be dropped. It is going to be a 2-1-1 now as Stim comes down and the Starport starts as well. So very standard on both sides of things. But we do have a Baneling Nest down as well, so that'll help out and try to hold this drop a bit.
Yep. 100% agree. Them's the facts. So a couple of scoutinglings. I'm going to go ahead and take the watchtower there as more lings do move out. As you said, there is a Baneling Nest down. Is there any Evo or are these drops? Or no, this is straight up kind of just, you know.
Yeah, that's what I was waiting on too. Like, are we going to have an Evo chamber? Because this Overlord over here is looking like he wants to do some drops. But nothing yet. He's going to just flood in with a lot of lings. And to be honest, they might find a lot of damage. At least if nothing else, force a lift off of this natural, which would be huge at this stage of the game. I think he's got enough to wrap around the Marines and get them done. But we'll have to see. So.
Yeah. By the way, Swag Syndrome, what time zone are you in? And I'll let you know what time you need to be there.
Oh, yeah.
If you're down to do it.
Or we'll convert it to mountain
time. Don't talk to Sativa. The man can't handle time zones. Simple, man.
Yeah, it gets too hard. But these Banes, that is a shitload of Banes, man. They're trying to end this series really quick. He's got enough to poke through there completely. And I think, oh my god, knows it. Imba had to pull all of his SCVs. And I think that's a wrap, unfortunately, man. Oh, no, he's going to be able to clean this up with all of those Marines, man. Or he should.
Yep.
They have Stim.
That, honestly, it was really awesome using those SCVs to block the positioning there of the Lings and Banes, and even some target firing coming down from Imba as well. So very nicely played on him. He did lose 16 SCVs, but the good news is he's not dead at the moment.
I'm rooting for Giggle Bear. Oh, shit, you got fans in here, Giggle. Nice.
Dude, hell yeah.
But yeah, now that Stim is actually finished up, he's going to be able to Stim forward and get a lot of this done. He'll even be able to pick up and get out of there when these Banes get there. Oh, but through Stutter Step alone, it's not even going to come down to that, man. That was pretty impressive right there from Mr. Imba.
That's beautiful.
Yeah, man, I thought it was going to be game over just like that, but now I'm kind of second-guessing that, dude. He held in there rather well, and sure, he's down a little bit in Nikon, but because of mules, that doesn't really mean shit, dude. He should be able to hang in here pretty well.
And yeah, those Marines do clean up the rest of the Lings, but unfortunately there are more Lings attacking.
There's a mine.
Mine does get buried though, and it actually will hit these. Okay, yeah, I'm there. Nice.
Holy shit, yeah. Just having the game sense to know that the mine is complete overkill and unburrowing it so the shot doesn't go off, that's pretty nice, man. I like that move.
Yep, so, oh man, we even got an LIT fan in here. What's
no
up, dude?
Oh shit, lit hype? Nah. Okay, cool. Swag's going to help us out tomorrow. Thank you very much for adminning for that, too. That's really badass that you'd volunteer for that. Did you give him a time zone and everything?
He didn't, but if you want to PM it to me, that's cool, man. You don't have all to right. fucking let everybody know the time zone you live in.
I'm in EST time.
EST time?
So be around at like 7:45, man.
What? Don't what? No.
No.
Don't listen to this guy.
All right,
tomorrow for the tournament, man, we start that at 6 your time, right?
Yeah.
So that's I'm Central Time, so that's 7 o'clock my time.
And he was giving me shit
time
for it.
Is one more hour, dude. So what time is it? It's gonna be
6:45. All right, but yeah, these Marines coming in here trying to find a little bit of damage. They get elevated up into the main. I think there's enough links to pick this off. But it's going to come down to the runaround, and they kind of got picked off coming up that ramp as well. There's not enough queens, though, to clean up this medevac, and he's going to be able to get on out of here.
I lied. I'm talking shit at 7:45.
No, we're good. We're good, man.
Yeah. it's definitely 7:45. Confirmed, dude.
Yeah, absolutely. So
5 plus 2 is 7, guys.
But yeah, I'm starting to like Imba's position in this game a lot more. He held off that nasty aggression, and now he's starting to tie up the worker lead, too. He's now only down 5 workers in this.
I was liking his position from the very time that he logged into this game and selected his race as Terran, man.
Oh, shit. We got some Terran bias, guys.
I know, right? But this is really just good drop play, and even if he is taking trades here, it's really just about forcing Lings out. The number of medevacs in the sky allow these Marines to just be ungodly cost-efficient.
Yeah, absolutely. So, as you said, there's 4. There's damn near 1 medevac for every Marine. So, they're allowing just an insane amount of stims and just to be as annoying as possible. And you can tell it's starting to frustrate Bidet Nevin a little bit because he doesn't even have enough Lings to poke in here and clean it up. He should have maybe waited for some Banes or something, but that's really easy for us to say. Okay, with this reinforcement now, he should have enough to clean this up as long as he can stay away from that mine. But yeah, I got to like Imba's position. That was really good getting in there and getting all that damage done. And now he started to level out an Econ, which was huge for him. So he definitely hung in there, man. That was a very good hold for sure.
Yeah, I totally agree. He is coming back now. Does have a wall, which should help him sustain as there are no Banes in at the moment. But he's kind of going to, you know, have to defend a little bit here, make sure that he gets some decent Widowmine shots.
Yep, and we have a layer coming down for Vidae Nevin too. But oh, shit, these mines, man. Whew, if they would have been down, that would have been disastrous. But that's all good. I think he'll still be able to
hero
hold.
Mine. Hopefully I could see this one just outside of his base if these Lings come back home getting a decent shot.
Yeah. Yep, we'll have to see. That Overlord got denied as well that was poking in, so drop play is out of the question completely.
The Overlord. Oh wow, right in the choke too. So many Lings and a little bit of indecision there causing even more Lings to go down for Vidae Nevin. Really tough breaks. Oh my god. Okay.
Oh, I missed it.
No. It would just attack the front,
oh, okay.
Like leading Ling. So yeah. It definitely wasn't as bad as it could have been. But
that's
more...
why you never want to be the front Ling, man.
That's true. You got to be that point driver. Like, yeah. No.
But yeah, no, I don't know if he's really going to be able to clean this up, man. Vidae Nevin has Banelings, but he's just kind of streaming in his units, and they're kind of getting all picked off through insane splits and stutter steps. So.
So these last Lings will get hit by the Baneling, or by the Widowmine. Actually, more Lings do come in now. Oh, trigger off that one mine, dude.
This is a scrappy-ass game, dude. I'm really happy that this was the end. I didn't want it to be all over in a minute, but this has been really back and forth so far. It's been a really nice series-ending game. But I think it's going to start spiraling out of control here for Imba's favor, man. Look at that production he's got gearing up. Double medevacs, double mines, and he's got a shitload of Marines coming out on top of the mine traps everywhere that he already has going. So I really like his position.
Yeah. Absolutely, man. I totally agree. he's got these Widow Mines out here, too, which are really nice. It doesn't look like any sort of detection. Oh, God, these Lings.
Oh!
Oh, yeah, man. Definitely. Every unit's so important right now,
yeah.
Especially with these Marines marching across the map. And I'm surprised, man. I haven't seen any sort of detection. There we go.
Look
coming
at this.
From Vedin Evan.
This hero mine has 28 kills, dude, or 26
wow.
Still. But, yeah, that's really good. His splits, though. Look at that, man. His splits
Solid
are insane.
Splits. Yep. And I think with that, especially with the Overseer going down, Creep being cleaned back up, we should see Terran start to take a fairly significant lead in these engagements.
Yeah.
Target firing the Banelings even. Very nice, man.
Yeah, the one thing Vidae Nevin has going for him, though, is that Baneling speed is about to finish up here, so that'll help out a lot. Maybe if he can just kind of... Oh, shit, he's actually going in with his Queens. Oh, no, he lost his Queens. There was no Transfuse available, and now he's going to get picked off rather convincingly. Okay. Now he's starting to work on the medevacs. I think he'll be able to stabilize here. I think, if anything, he's just trying to really delay until he can get that Bane speed that just now finished up. Oh, he doesn't have any Banes, though. Sir, you need Banes.
Yeah, and there's another, you know, 2 full Ooh. Medevacs, I think, that just dropped off Marines. It should be a stim right into the Queens and just kill him. Vedin Evan is doing a damn good job. I would have died, you know, 5 times over
Oh, yeah,
by now,
absolutely.
For sure. But I think this with this wave of bio, we're going to start to see a significant amount of drones go down, Lings being cleaned up.
Oh, yeah, and it's not like Imba didn't have to work for it or anything like that. That hold was insane. His splits have been phenomenal. So, you know, he's definitely had to work for it, but it's paid off definitely. For sure. And I don't think Vedin Evan's going to be able to stabilize from here on out. Just losing that third is huge, and as you said, there are continual drops just coming in 2 at a time. As soon as he has enough for 2 medevacs, he loads them up and moves them on out.
Yep. So the Lings are going to continue to stream in and do as much damage as possible, but Vidae Nevin knows it, and unfortunately calls GG.
Yep, and that will be it. man, what a crazy ass game and a crazy ending. So, man, just like that, they'll take it. Yeah, that was
that is awesome, man. Yep. Yeah, but
so congrats. Oh, sorry.
I love this event, dude. It's really awesome. Yeah, I don't mean to cut you off, but seeing those maps and different teams and these players, and just a huge shout out again to Tech4 and all the CTL guys for helping us out. It's their event. We just cast it. They invited us to cast it, but we really appreciate the opportunity.
Yep, absolutely. So congratulations to ConFed, and again, a huge thank you to both Formless Bear Sloths and ConFed for letting us cast it. Shout out to Allen and Tech4 specifically for including this on this, and I hope you guys have appreciated it. That will conclude the festivities for tonight. We don't have anything else going on, but tomorrow we'll be back with our Plat Diamond tournament, and Sunday we have a $50 clan war between Psystorm and Eastloth. So thank you guys very much for tuning in, and go follow GiggleBear on Twitch at twitch.tv/GiggleBear. So you got anything or what, GiggleBear?
Yeah, go if you're gonna take the time, go follow me. You should definitely go follow Sortiva as well. Thanks again, guys, for watching. We love doing these clan wars. As you said, we got another one on Sunday, and we got the tournament tomorrow at 6 p.m. Mountain Time. Really, that's it, man. Thanks, guys. Thanks again to Tech4 and all the guys from CTL, and we'll see you guys tomorrow.
All right, cool. Who should we host? But yeah, we'll see you guys later. Tomorrow, actually. See you guys then.
Stream in and do as much damage as possible, but we never know who to host.
Yeah, let's figure out who to host. But all right, guys, we're going to cut it off there.